We've got rain in the metro right now, so be aware of that. But I want to talk about forecast models. So let's look at what's happening with Invest99L. Here is a look at the forecast models, and you can see there is one trend taking the system to the north, right along the west coast of Florida, and another one taking it to the west. So you're thinking, what's up with that, right? Well, let me show you. High pressure is going to build right there in the Atlantic. Keep in mind, with high pressure, you have a clockwise flow. So it's easy to see how a system could actually move north over Florida. But we also have high pressure that's going to be building across Louisiana, at least according to the GFS model. So that could actually take something to the west. That's why we're getting these two different scenarios. All right, let's look at Invest99L. We're looking at it right now. Kind of hard to see it. Now, this is the visible, but you can see there's the circulation, but there is not a closed low-level circulation. Air Force reconnaissance plane went in, and they actually found the pressure is not that low either. All right, back home, we've got some rain. We've got some storms. The good news is it wasn't as hot today. High pressure to the east, and look at how we've got this little area of disturbed weather moving to the west. That's what caused all of our rain today. Started off in the morning, which is why we didn't get as hot, but we're not done. Look, down here along the coast, Timbaleer Bay moving over towards Dulac, you've got some thunderstorm activity. Also on up to Des Solomons, and then right there at Laplace, that's some pretty heavy rain right now, 113 lightning strikes in just 15 minutes. This is the rain that moved right over the station. It's now heading to the west into Jefferson and Metairie, so be aware of that. On the North Shore, it's beginning to die down. Still some activity basically over Tangipahoa Parish. So as we look at the rainfall totals, some of us got some locally heavy rain, 1 to 2 inches. Here's the forecast model, shows that rain moving to the west, and then we pretty much have it dying down overnight. Could have a little bit of patchy fog. In the morning, we're looking pretty good. A few showers as we're going to the noontime hours. But the truth is, I really don't see as much rain for tomorrow. I've got it at about a 30% chance. Now, you know what that means. When there's less rain, there is more heat. High temperatures, I think, are going to be more in the mid-90s. I do have a higher chance of rain for Saturday, about a 50% chance. Actually knocked it down a little bit as you go into Sunday, a 40% chance. The good news about the rain, a beautiful rainbow. That one was sent in, as you can see, by Sue Foster. Thank you so much, Sue. And by the way, over towards Baton Rouge, that flood advisory has been extended. 90 was the high temperature today, about the area near 92. Mid-90s over towards Hammond. It's 84 degrees now at the airport. That's because we're rain-cooled. And you can see upper 70s to the mid-80s. As we go to the 9 o'clock hour, upper 70s to the mid-80s. Morning low temperatures, mid-70s to near 80 degrees. And your high temperatures tomorrow, I think, are going to be in the mid-90s. It's going to be a hot day. So as we look at that forecast, 3 in the afternoon, about 95 degrees. That better chance of rain for Saturday, Sunday a decent shot as well. But next week, if that system Invest99L goes to our east, it's going to be hot. High temperatures mid-90s, a 30% chance of rain. All right.